Marinette YouTube, this is Crystal Dragonfly, hoping happiness has found you on this Thursday. Why don't you grab you a cup of coffee or tea? For a little chitty chat about, talking a little bit about Earth Day coming up on April 22nd. If you didn't know that, well, and if you just forgot, well, that's my, it's a reminder today. And of course, our quote for the day is, you know guys, my memory just shot to crap lately. Every morning we are born again. What we do today is what matters most. Every morning we are born again. What we do today is what matters most. And that is by Buddha. Buddha. Alright, so. Earth Day. April 22nd is Earth Day. Why not make, instead of just one specific friggin' day for Earth Day, make it the month of April. Okay, guys? Let's think of the month of April as for Earth. Instead of that one darn day, everybody gonna do something. Do something. Try to do as many things as you can this month for Earth. But if not, get at least something planted, guys, for Earth. You know, I know shit's expensive. I know some flowers out there, plants for your yard, are expensive. I hear you, but a packet of seeds don't cost very much. A dollar? Not even a dollar. I know you're not going to get a fast, quick thing with those, but in the long run, you're going to do really well. I am asking that each of you, sometime this month, plant some wildflowers for the bees. Bees need flowers, and wildflowers are some of the best ones. I love my honey, and not just honey, bees do so much more. I know a lot of people are sick and tired of hearing about the bees going bye-bye and things like that, but bees and the flowers and Earth can't talk about it, so we need to. I ask if nothing else you do this month or on the day of Earth Day is buy some wildflowers and plant. Like I said, they can be seeds. They don't have to be deep, you know. Less than a dollar, buy you a pack, go out, kind of scratch up that dirt a little bit, throw them on there. You don't have straw or something, put friggin' leaves on top of it, guys. That does work. It keeps the birds from getting up. It'll help them grow. You don't have to have a lot of money to plant something. In the summer, you know what I do? I will go out and into the wild and dig up one of the plants that I like that has the flowers on it. Just one. I don't take out the whole thing. I take one and bring it and I plant it on my hill. And most likely, it's going to come back. There are a few times, yeah, it does die, but I'm trying. You know, I'm trying to bring in the more wild stuff that everybody calls weeds and things, because they have purposes. Most of them have magical purposes, most of them have health purposes. So I'm trying to make my hill and my yard my that type of a hill. So, please, Earth Day, plant some friggin' wildflowers for the bees, for the earth, for everything. For yourself. Get out there and get your hands in the dirt and get grounded again and get all that goodness. Yeah. It won't take you very long, and let me tell you, you will feel a lot better afterwards. I'm sure you're thinking at work, but no. So please do something. On top of I'm doing wildflowers on my hill, a big, big chunk of it, I'm also going to go find some really cheap flowers, packets, and I'm going to write Happy Earth Day, and I'm going to go put them on people's, hand them out on Earth Day. You know, I'm going to try at least do 10 to hand out for people to plant for Earth Day. Not expensive, it's really cheap, and it's a way to get people out there. You know, a lot of people, they get seeds or something, they'll plant them. Or they'll give them to somebody they know that'll plant them. So that's my way this month of giving back for Earth Day. I'm also going to plant some flowers. I'm going to plant some snapdragons. I don't know when they'll get this month, though. This weather's just going up and down, up and down, up and down. But you can plant seeds. Alright, so please, do something. Let me know what you do for Earth Day. That's what I'm going to do. But please, do something. Alright, so the doodle of the day is roots. I think it's appropriate considering what we're talking about. Because one little thing on a tree, they keep going down. The roots go down, down, down. They lead to the city. And bees are connected by roots to so many things. And flowers are connected to so many things. Butterflies, hummingbirds, birds, because birds eat, you know. It's just amazing. So here's my underground. I got a bird eating a worm. I got ants underground, all kinds of worms. I got a goddamn mole. Got some rocks, some bones, some of those, snail slugs, mold, those things underground are nasty. Do you all having horrible mold troubles these last couple years? My God, I know that sounds like a commercial, doesn't it? Here in Kansas, and this, I just think it's everybody around, have horrible mold. You break your freaking ankle walking into my yard most days. It's crazy. Little bastards. And my moles are smart. You know, yeah, I may be a witch. And, you know, but I'm not a vegan. I eat meat. I like meat. I don't go out and kill animals for no reason or anything like that. And I can't use to get rid of the moles, the sonic sound thing, because it does get rid of squirrels, bunnies, and things like that. We have a lot of them. But I tried putting poison out for those little fuckers, and I shit you not, they pushed them out of their holes. Yeah, they pushed the poison, the pellets, and I tried those fake wormy things out of the holes and left them on the ground. I shit you not. That must have super intelligent moles. Anywho. I hope you guys have a great day. Let me know in the bottom comments what you're doing for Earth Day. Do something, guys. Make us, especially on this path, proud. And any human being out there can do something for Earth Day. You live on it, take care of it. Bye.